Howdy, audio folks. Welcome back to the channel. MrAyrit here, and we've got a special review for you today because we are going to be reviewing Stax's brand new flagship, the X9000. Now, before we get into the review here, let me just say I was kind of shocked when I got this thing. I guess I didn't understand exactly what it was that I was getting that my friend sent to me, which I'm going to drop his YouTube channel down below. He's not necessarily doing audio reviews, but he asked me to get the word out that he's got a channel out there, so why not spread the love here? So if you want to go check that out, that'd be appreciated. Also, you know, while you're down there poking around, consider giving a like and subscribe to the channel if you're interested in more headphone audio content. Okay, but I didn't realize I was getting like the top of the line. Like, I guess I just didn't realize what this thing was. Okay, I'm going to show you the opening of it because it's kind of special, and and I was just pretty impressed when I was doing that, and then we'll jump back into the review here. Okay, so yeah, I am gonna gush about the build of this thing. Boy, it is just one of the coolest headphones that I've ever seen. All the materials, you know, feel pretty good. I love the colorway. It's kind of a gunmetal gray, maybe like a slight tinge of blue to it. You know, suspension strap, headband feels good. I mean, just everything. Look at how cool it looks in there. You know, you've got this interesting little like screen that's out here on it. Pads are nice and big and comfy. I mean, it's a pretty lightweight headphone, very comfortable on the head. Maybe I might, you know, the clamp is a little light, you know, so to where it will kind of move around on your head a little bit, but boy, it's comfortable. And I mean, it's not a crazy departure from the 009s, which I have right here, which also feel really well built and stuff. It just feels a little bit more special than this, a little more refined. I mean, you can kind of just see it as you look at them side by side. Just the X9000 really takes it to the next level as far as just design goes, you know? I mean, comfort is largely the same. I would say it's really quite similar in the system feels, and the size of it and everything like that. Just everything just feels a little bit nicer on the X9000. The other big bonus, I think, with the X9000 is detachable cables, which it came with a couple of different lengths, which is really cool. Specifically, you've heard me, if you've been around the channel at all, I use most of my stuff at my desk, so I like shorter cables. And you know, the 007, it's got, you know, maybe like a 7-8 foot cable on it, which I found to be a bit cumbersome. So it was really nice for me to be able to use the nice short one that came with the new X9000. All of my listening was done with the LTA Z10E, which was a crazy amplifier. You know, it's like a $7,000 E-Stat regular headphone tube integrated amp. Like, that thing is wild. I'll link that review down below. So a very, very capable amplifier, but it comes with an asterisk, right? Because that's the only ESTAT amplifier that I had, and I don't have a whole lot of experience with ESTATs. I did own for a while the Stax, it was like the Stax 500 system or something like that. It was like an L300 with a 252S driver. And, you know, I thought that was great value for the money for about like a $500 system. But that's the only other ESTAT. Well, I tried a really cheap Monoprice one at one point. So very limited ESTAT experience for me. Now, a couple of things. This is mainly going to be a review of the X9000. I did listen to the 009 quite a bit as well. But, I mean, clearly the X9000 is the more capable, more enjoyable. I just thought better all around. So I'm not really going to talk about the 009 sound all that much. Just know that if you like the 009, I mean, and you're wondering, is it worth the upgrade to the X9000? It's hard for me to tell you to spend those thousands of dollars, but I think from a objective, what is it capable of perspective, the X9000 does easily beat the 009s. And just everything sounded better on it. The separation, the details, the timbre, the bass response, just everything in my ears was better on the X9000. And so that's what really we're going to be diving into in this review. So what are you getting with the X9000? Well, it's, again, not knowing how much it would play or change with different electrostatic amplifiers. Boy, it is just the pinnacle of crystalline, clean, precise neutrality is what I would say. Just the amounts of detail in this thing is crazy. It is the fastest headphone I have heard by far. I mean, just every little itty bitty detail, every little grain of texture, you get all of that with this thing. It throws a pretty wide sound stage. Black background on the Z10E, and just surgical with where everything is within the soundstage on it. And it's to the point where it's like, normally I wouldn't go for this type of the super, super cleanly sound. Like, I'm much more of like a tube dynamics person at this point in time. But if that's the type of sound that you are really after, this thing is, it's the best example of that I've heard. So just very fast, very detailed. Timbre, though, is still really, really good. I mean, I would say that it does do the ESTAT thing where it can feel, not thin isn't really the word, but just like almost like papery with like its speed and precision. You're still, if you're a bass head, like, this thing is not gonna pound your ears. But I did find that it took reasonably well to EQ. So I had my Lokius hooked up to this thing to get my level of enjoyment up with this headphone, just because it is such a flat, neutral response. Is I would actually boost the mid bass a little bit, and I would boost kind of the lower treble a little bit, just to give things a little more bite, to add a little more sizzle to it. And that would bring it a little more to life for me. So I used the Lokius to do that. And when I would do that, it would pull me in a little bit more than it does with just its stock tuning, which, again, is just, it's so utterly clean and precise. Like, to me, it didn't draw me in as much as some other headphones do. So a couple of headphones that I've just really been enjoying lately are this set of Atours that I traded for. I've been loving those. And then the Klipsch HP3s. I've been loving those as well. And if I'm being totally honest, I would probably reach for those if I'm going for pure enjoyment more of the time than I would for the X9000. Now, that's not saying I couldn't sit down and enjoy a listening session with the X9000, because I absolutely could. I just don't know that it's quite my bag. I've been much more into the tube dynamic, you know, biocellulose stuff where they're just kind of thick and rich and got a lot of slam and things like that. Now, even though I enjoy those headphones more, I mean, certainly they don't technically, you know, compete with the X9000. There's probably very few headphones that really do. Of the ones that I've tried, I would think that this would fall, you know, in the realm of something like the LCD5. I would think it'd be very similar to, although the LCD5 I didn't think was as easy listening as this guy was. That's a very fast, precise, detailed headphone, but this guy is a little bit smoother, I would say. Whereas the LCD5 I kind of get tired of after a little while. This guy I could leave on for as long as I wanted and it wouldn't grate on me really. Especially coming out of the Z10E with this guy, like, it just, everything is so smooth but yet super detailed that it just, it takes you right up to the edge of like neutrality where things probably should be getting harsh, and on lots of other headphones that aren't as capable, it does get harsh and a little sibilant and it starts to grate on you a little bit. Not with these guys. Like, you just get to see all that detail, right? Like, that's what you're getting. Like, you just have unfiltered access to the detail in the recorded music that you're listening to. So I would take these over the LCD5 for sure. The new Utopia, I thought, was leaning more in this direction where over the old Utopia, where it's just a little more neutral. Definitely a fast and detailed headphone, more intimate than this guy is, and probably not refined quite to the level of the X9000. The other headphone that I know people are going to want to know about, but I don't know that I'm really prepared to do, I it would have been fantastic to have them side by side, but that'd be the Susvara. And, you know, just from what I remember about the Susvara, it's been long enough that, you know, we all know how audio memory can be, but I did love that headphone. And I think probably I would reach for it over the X9000. I just remember being really engaged with the Susvara and just felt like it really would just bring me in and had just so much detail, but also was a very organic listen. I wouldn't really call the X9000 organic. Again, it's more like crystalline, surgical, without ever getting too harsh or grating on me though. So that's pretty big praise coming from me for the X9000, I think, in just that it can have that type of a sound signature, but that I can still listen to it for long periods of time. So I mean, if that's the type of sound you're going for, clean, surgical, precise, you know, very black background, excellent imaging, you know, if that's the type of sound that you're looking for and you don't mind if it'd be a little bass light, and you don't mind if you don't get a lot of like richness in the tones, then certainly this guy would be one to look for. So feel very privileged for having had the opportunity to listen to this and the Z10E, and again, that's linked down below the review for that. I should say too that the Bifrost 264 was my source during this test, so I actually felt like I had to go out and buy that because I was just using my RU6 and I knew people would be like, oh, RU6, you know, you're not getting everything out of it, which granted, people are probably gonna say that about the Bifrost 264 too, but that is a pretty impressive DAC, and that review will be coming here before too long as well. So yeah, it's been fun to try this little foray into this really expensive gear. Again, I said in my other video that, you know, the X9000 and the Z10E together is like $13,000, which basically is what my first home cost, which was a mobile home. So it's kind of interesting to try to sit here and review audio equipment that, like, literally you could go buy someplace to live in for that amount of money. Certainly a nice used car anyway. So pretty crazy stuff, but it's definitely fun to try out. Again, hard for me to justify that money on a teacher's salary, and so I won't, but if you know, $13,000 for a headphone setup doesn't bother you, then, and you want that clean sound, look no further, I'd say. So yeah, questions, comments, have you heard this thing, any of that stuff, go ahead and drop it down below. I always love that kind of engagement. Even if you've got alternative opinions and stuff like that, I always welcome that. Thanks for watching. Thanks to the friend that sent these out, gave me the opportunity to hear these. And, you know, hopefully I'll see you in the next one for some more, you know, headphone and audio reviews. I appreciate you. We'll see you next time.